Hi there friends, I'm Eric. Today we are going to learn a skill which is going to be useful to you your entire life. As long as you work for somebody or you have a business, you are going to do this. And that skill is the art of writing letters. Right? So we are going to learn how to write good, effective letters. Now, in the context of your examination, letter writing is of 5 or 6 marks. So we will not require, or we are not required to write large letters. But yeah, the fundamentals remain the same. So we will write small, effective letters, but we'll get the formats right. And we'll also learn how to word them, how to think about them. So I'm going to do a series of videos covering this topic. In this video, I'm just going to introduce you to letter writing. Okay, so there are normally two types of letters. We have a formal letters and then we have friendly letters, right? We have friendly letters. Now, a formal letter doesn't mean they are sad letters, right? Don't get it wrong, okay? But they are official letters. So we can say they are official letters, we can say they are business letters, and informal letters are the friendly letters, they are the personal letters, right? So I am going to write the word personal up here. Okay, we'll talk a little bit more about them right now. So what's a friendly letter? What's an informal letter? So it's written to friends, that's why it's friendly, obviously. Acquaintances. Acquaintance means jaan pehchan ke log. People you know but are not very good friends with. So you may have lots of acquaintances, you may have a few friends, and you may have 1, 2, 3, 4 very good friends, best friends, right? So best friends langotia yaar are very few. Friends a little more. Acquaintances are much more. Okay? And then we have relatives. Again, a large amount of people who you can term as your relatives. And then from that, we have a smaller amount of people called family. Right? So, we can just say like best friends are a small group of people. A small set. A bigger set would be all your friends. And a larger set would be your friends plus your acquaintances. And same thing, we can say you have all your relatives, everybody who is related to you, a set R, and a smaller part of this would be your immediate family. Okay, so all letters to all of these people are informal letters, or we can say they are friendly letters. Why? Because the tone and flow of such letters is friendly. That's why we call them friendly letters. Yeah, obviously, if you write to a relative or a friend, or your family member, you won't say, oh, yaar, you will not use any superlatives up here, okay? But it is friendly tone, it is more personal, right? It is more personal, that's the main word, it's more personal. The flow of the letter, the tone of the letter. Why? Because the receiver of the letter knows you, right? The receiver, the reader of the letter will know you. And so you can be more personal. You can share funny things. You can share your experiences. You can share your thoughts. Right? Your adventures. Right? You can share your follies, all your mistakes. See, all of these are personal things. You can share all of them. All of these. So that's why it's a friendly letter. If you want to understand what a friendly letter is or how to write a friendly letter, just think of this. If you lift a phone and speak to your friend, how will you speak? That's exactly how a friendly letter should shape out. Not only that, my personal way of writing a letter is I always go for a conversation in my mind. If I were to phone somebody, even an official, How will I speak to that person? That person cannot see my face, does not know me. How will I speak to that person? Same thing to my friend. That my friend living in Bombay, I don't know him. Oh, sorry, I am not present with him right now. If I lift my mobile and I call him, how will I talk to him? Right? That same tone, that same flow we are going to use while phoning that person, we are going to use while writing. That makes a very good letter, my friends, right? That makes a good letter. Remember this. We are going to practice. I'll show you that. Okay. Now let's talk of formal letters. These are written to officials, anybody in an official position, like a manager of a company, it can be the principal of your school, it can be a teacher of your school, it can be a government official, etc. Anybody in an official position. A letter written to such a person is called a formal letter. The tone of such letters is formal. Formal means it is not personal. You cannot call him a friend, right? He's an official, an office bearer, and you have to write your tone. The letter should be written in such a way that it meets that official, okay? That wavelength should match. Now, the opposite person, the receiver, the official, may or may not know you. Let's see, like your principal knows you, your teacher knows you, but a manager of a company, a manager in a hotel, a manager in a place where you're applying for or complaining, or a government official to whom you're writing a letter may not know you. So the wordings of the letter are to be chosen very carefully. Right? It's like this, okay? You lift your phone and you call somebody. Let's say I call you. You don't know me. Right? Directly. I will not go and start talking to you in a friendly way or in a way in which you are left guessing, okay, why did I call, who am I? Right? I'm going to use a sequence, a logic to write to talk to you, right? There's a logical sequence how you talk to a stranger. This logical sequence, the choosing of the words have to be done very carefully in this formal letter. It's not hard, friends, right? It is not hard at all. I'll show you the trick. I'll show you the logic you have to use in the in the subsequent videos when we cover these letters. And you'll find it's a piece of cake. Writing letters from henceforth will be easy for you. Just remember what I'm teaching you. Just keep these videos with you all through your college life, even your while you work or in business. Keep these videos with you. It will always be useful to you. Okay, so even if the person is known to us, like your principal, your teacher, they are known to you. But since it is an official letter, it should be kept impersonal. Right? It should be kept formal. Right? The tone of the letter, right, is kept formal. Even though the person may be friendly with you, your teacher may be a very friendly teacher, you may be very comfortable with the teacher. While you're talking with the teacher, you can talk in a nice way, comfortable way. But if you're writing a letter, a formal letter to your teacher, then the tone will have to be kept impersonal. Yeah, if you're writing a friendly letter to your teacher, a personal letter, then it's a different matter. But a formal letter, let's say you're asking for leave from your teacher, leave from school, then obviously the tone will have to be kept impersonal. Based on this, let's talk of the types of formal letters and then we end this video session. So there are four main types of formal letters which are asked in your portion. Normally for a student, right, for a student, you will be made to write four different type of formal letters. See, I'm not talking of the friendly letter. We also have a friendly letter, but informal letters. You may be asked to write a letter of complaint. Right? So the key word is the complaint letter to a government official regarding some issue you are facing, or a letter stating some problem. So it's a problem letter. Right? You are stating some problem which needs to be solved by the official. So this is a complaint letter or a problem letter. Okay. Then second would be a business letter. written to a manager, your principal, your teacher, requesting for some information or some action which he or she has to take, or even leave from school, right? So it's a business letter. Then we have a letter written to the editor of a newspaper. Why we are writing to the newspaper editor? To draw his attention to some problem and asking his help in highlighting the matter so that it comes to the attention of the authorities. Now remember, the format of this letter will be the same, more or less the same as a complaint letter. So we will not treat it differently. We'll treat it more like a complaint letter. But the letter is not directly written to the official. It is written to the editor, asking for his help in highlighting the matter through his paper so that it comes to the attention of the authorities. It is more effective, right? Sometimes you start writing a letter to the official and he's not acting, he's not taking action. Despite your efforts, nothing happens. Then you resort to writing to the editor, because once the matter comes in the press, it's a matter of shame, more people will get to know. So the concerned authority gets worried and they will start acting. And the fourth type of formal letter, which normally a student will have to write, is an application for a job. This will normally be a part of your standard 11th and standard 12th portion. So in standard 11th and 12th, mainly especially in 12th board, for Gujarat board at least I know, job application letter is a compulsory thing. This is not there. For 9, 10, 11 portion, maybe you have a formal letter, informal letter. Right? But for 12th standard, we have a job application letter only. So we'll learn about that, how to write a proper forwarding letter and also how to write a proper bio letter. Okay? So these are the types of formal letters. I'll be taking up the different type of formal letters. I'll be showing you how to write a complaint letter. So this letter, first letter, I'll be showing you how to write this. I'll be showing you how to write a business letter. Right? I'll be showing you how to write a job application. I may be speaking about how to write an editorial letter. At the same time, I'll also show you how to write an informal letter. Right? So we'll cover all these topics in the subsequent videos, and I'm very sure by the time I'm finished with you, you will be very comfortable writing letters. But yeah, friends, remember one thing: just seeing this video and understanding the format won't make you proficient enough to be able to write good letters every time. It's a matter of practice. Two things are required while writing a letter. First is word power. Oh, let's say three things. Okay, three things. First is word power. You should have words with you. Your English should be at that level that you have many words with which you can play. The second very important thing is your grammar should be okay. Your tenses especially. Right? You don't write present tense and past tense and future tense in one sentence itself. We don't make bail of our tenses. Right? We keep it present tense, simple present tense. As much as possible, our letters are in simple present tense. We will not use continuous tense, perfect tense, perfect continuous. We don't use that. We keep it in simple present. Right? Some things we have to mention as simple past. That's it. Our tense have to be very particular. And then the logic of the letter, the content of the letter has to be formulated in your mind. Like I said earlier, you have to think in such a way that you are talking to that person on a phone. And if you are going to talk on the phone, what are you going to say? How will you say it? What are the first things you will say? Then what will you say? Then after that, what will you say? That is the logic of the speech. And the same logic of spoken word, speech, will also come to the written word, the letter. Okay, friends? So, meet you in the subsequent videos. Okay. So, bye.